I'm almost sort of as obsessed with the dark as much as the lights. I spent a lot of time with my grandfather as a child growing up, and he was a carpenter. And most weekends, he looked after me, and I spent a lot of time with him as a kid. So that sort of craft where you create something out of essentially nothing, a bit of wood, when something's just been born out of nothing, I think that's something that I take forward in my life now. I quite like the applied approach that we have in lighting. We sort of remove some darkness, so it's like sort of shaving away some of the medium to reveal something underneath. I guess the ethos I have is to really try and focus on the story and to try and understand what's trying to be achieved and said, whether it's a facade of a building, whether it's a residential apartment, whether it's a commercial space. Normally there's a story that's trying to be told. It's always really important to have that like a thread, a vein of some sort of narrative that's running through it all, so that you can reinforce the identity of the project. I think it's really important to pay attention to textures. I try as much as possible to always appreciate, look around and not just look straight ahead, focusing on the small, nuanced elements of beauty that are just everywhere. The way that different materials play with each other, and textures and forms, and the way that light plays with them. So my main point that I try and focus on is, how do you feel when you're in that space? So it's really important to create an environment or a moment that everyone reacts to and has an emotional response to. The future of lighting, definitely there's more of an awareness of lighting in terms of energy consumption, so you know, practicality to preserving the world around you. And I think that sort of consideration means that challenges for lighting designers are slightly harder. Things are always being challenged, and I think we'd be foolish to not try and question some of the things we do. I think it's important to always change the perspective of how you view something. Taking a step back sometimes and trying to look at it from a different side, it completely changes the form of the object you're looking at. And I think as long as you raise that status quo and you raise that bar slightly, and you've delivered something that is different and unique, is a new way, a new standard of looking at things. Because if everyone in London or Europe or the world is looking at the same thing the same way, nothing's ever going to be different.